The question isn't, are we alone in the universe? It's, are we alone in these universes? According to a bit of the cosmic microwave background radiation, we might have a neighbor right there. This is the cosmic microwave background radiation, or CMB. It's the leftover light from the Big Bang itself. It's the furthest light from us in the visible universe. In fact, it's everywhere you look, if you could see it, which you can't because it's in the microwave spectrum. It would glow everywhere, and it is constantly all around us. But it's super low energy, because again, it's been around since the beginning of the universe. Over time, we've taken the CMB's temperature and mapped it in increasing detail, and in doing so, we found something curious. See, usually the CMB is pretty uniform in temperature, about 2.73 Kelvin, only deviating a few microkelvin across the whole CMB, except in one place, the cold spot. For some reason, there, it skews colder than the average temperature by a few microkelvin. No big deal for a tiny area, but this is consistent across a huge region. It's a billion light years across. This spot challenges what we know about the universe. What is this thing? How did it get there? Astronomers have been fighting about the cold spot for years, and they've come up with a few theories. The cosmic texture hypothesis says if you analyze the CMB in this way, it's just a bumpy part of the cosmos. The cluster hypothesis says there are clusters of galaxies that may affect the CMB as we perceive it, which is similar to the supervoid hypothesis, which states that it was only in that cold spot because of our perspective. Because in between the CMB and Earth is a supervoid, a cooler, less galaxy-dense region of space. The most banal theory is that it exists because the satellite instruments or analysis has some math error. But the most fantastical could also be one of the most likely, that the cold spot is cold because it's where the edge of our universe touched the edge of another universe. The reason it's gained some ground is because the supervoid theory was strongly refuted in May of 2017. Apparently, astronomers don't think that voids that super could exist. Either way, none of these theories are 100%, so that gets back to the crazy exotic physics answer. At some point, our universe might have bumped into another universe, leaving a bruise. This is based on ideas of the multiverse theory. In the 1920s, famous physicists Niels Bohr and Werner Heisenberg kicked us into the quantum physics theory of superposition. The idea that an infinite number of universes are possible and they're all overlapping on each other. But because we're observing the universe, we can only see one of them. So think of Schrödinger's cat, a cat in a box with a vial of poison that could break at any time. This thought experiment wouldn't be an issue because of superposition. There's no observer, so the cat is both alive and dead in two separate universes. This isn't a huge deal for quantum mechanics, but earth-shattering for regular physics in our observable universe. Obviously, I'm simplifying a lot here for the sake of time, but it's all very confusing. Suffice it to say, the math does work. But if infinite universes are out there, how could one universe even physically touch another universe anyway? There are a lot of questions, and there aren't really a lot of answers. Some people even say it's impossible to prove, while others say the whole thing is unprovable, period. And still others say it's just an unlikely natural event. If it's not a supervoid or a multiverse bruise, say physicists, then our assumptions of the universe based on our standard model of physics might just be off by a little bit. According to the newest study author, the craziest sounding of the exotic models for the explanation of the cold spot, the multiverse, is actually the most standard in terms of our current model of the universe. In the end, we can't 100% say it's not another universe. And I, for one, welcome our universe neighbors who are also ourselves. I know that that was all mind-blowing, but we're not actually done yet. The universe is expanding in all directions at once, which we can tell by watching the CMB. But what's on the other side? What's outside the universe? We have a video about that right here. What do you think the cold spot is? Let us know in the comments below. Please subscribe for more videos. Like, share, and come find us on Twitter @Seeker or me @Trace Dominguez. And thanks for watching.